So now that you have your Terraform binary installed and ready to go, but you don't really know where to go from here, or what exactly, what commands to use and whatnot, you can use the Terraform built-in documentation, or man pages, as a quick reference guide to what commands to use. You can get to that in three different ways. You can just do a Terraform command by itself, which will give you a list of your commands. You can also do a Terraform-H for help. Or you can do a Terraform --help. Either of those will bring up this nice list of commands that you can use. Has them separated with your main commands up here, and then all your other commands. You can also do a Terraform and then subcommand, and then use the help -h or the --help to then pull up a list of subcommands to use with the subcommands. So let's go over a few of these commands here, the ones I like to use a lot. Usually when I first start off with my Terraform configuration, I want to make sure that everything is formatted correctly. So I use this FMT command first, once I write my Terraform configuration. What this does is it'll reformat your configuration in the standard style. So it'll make sure that spacing and everything else is correct and proper. And you'll just run Terraform and then space FMT. And if it comes back blank, that means your configuration files within your working directory are correctly formatted. And if it does format a file, it'll let you know which file it touched. Then after I use the format command, then I jump over here to our main commands. You'll want to initialize your working directory, which this will prepare the directory for what you need. It'll look at your configuration files and it'll determine which providers and modules it needs to pull down from the registry to allow your configuration to work properly. Once you've initialized the directory, it's good to run a Terraform validate. A good thing to note here is that you cannot run the validate command before you run the init command. It will not work. So you must initialize the working directory first, then you can run the validation. Your validation will catch things like syntax error, version errors, stuff like that. It's a really good thing to do before you run your plan or apply. Next, it's always good to run your plan to see what it's going to actually do. It is a nice dry run of your apply plan. You can even use one of the subcommands with plan to actually output your plan to apply it later. Then, of course, you have your apply command, which is one of the commands you're going to use the most. This is where it will deploy your or apply your configuration to a provider. Then, obviously, the destroy command, which will destroy all of your infrastructure, or when used with the target flag, just a single or individual resources within your infrastructure. Some other commands that I like to use here are your output command. If you put together a good output variable file, you're able to use this command to use those defined outputs to display certain information. Like, say if you were deploying EC2 instances, you can output tag names or instance names or instance ID or the IP of the instance and so on and so forth. So you can gather some really good information that can be used later on to make it simple to look up. Also, if you're working as a team, it's nice so people can come behind you and use that output command to figure out certain things and kind of get up to speed. Some other good ones to use, the Terraform show command. I will show your current state of a saved plan. It collects a good amount of information about your infrastructure that you've deployed. It's a good way to check and see, like, say if you had an EC2 instance or, you know, a VM or something that was deployed in your configuration, it'll show you things like the state that it's in, like if it's up and it's ready, or if it's being terminated, or so on and so forth. And you can gather information like IP address, stuff like that, and just general useful information. Another good way to check your work is using the state command, which you can find out information like if you use the Terraform show state and then the subcommand list, it'll give you a list of the resources that are being managed by your configuration. So if you didn't need all that extra information, the state list command is a nice way to give a nice consolidated list of resources you're managing with your configuration. Then obviously the version, you'll use that quite a bit to check your Terraform version, especially if you have any version conflicts. Sometimes providers only work with certain versions of Terraform, so you kind of have to, if you're defining those versions within your configuration, sometimes they can get a little sticky, so yeah, you'll tend to use that version command here and there. And just like I said before, you can use the help command with subcommands as well. So like I said before, the state command has quite a few subcommands. So let's go ahead and look at that. We do a Terraform state and then use the dash H. And now it'll give you some more information about the state command and then its list of subcommands. So here's the list one that I was talking about, where it lists the resources in the state. If you are going from a local Terraform instance to, say, you wanted to start backing up your state in a remote backend, you would use this state move command to move your state file to that backend. You'll probably run into situations where you'll need to use that command a few times. Just like the Terraform show command, there's a state show command, which shows a resource in the state. You can remove instances from a state by using the rm command and the push and pull, which is used mostly with remote state. So those are just some of the popular commands, kind of in a nutshell, stuff I like to use. This is a very handy way to quickly look up commands when you're not really 100% sure either how to use it or know what it does. It's definitely a useful tool when using Terraform, especially when getting started, so I highly suggest you take a look at it when you get a chance.